My name is Jonathan Highmarsh and I'm an advanced clinical pharmacist at Sunderland Royal Hospital and I specialise in palliative care. So in terms of the skills that the courses give you, it's that fundamental understanding of pharmacology and how that is applied clinically. In terms of the postgraduate courses with the prescribing and the clinical skills course that I undertook, it was about extending that learning from an undergraduate level so that I could further that to take it to the next level of not just being a pharmacist working in the background, but having those skills to be able to go and assess patients, to be able to go and manage patients, to apply my skills directly without some of the qualifications that I've done, like the prescribing course. I wouldn't be able to take responsibility for the decisions that I make. Having those courses allowed me to progress to that higher level. It allows me to have a greater autonomy in my job, work more closely with patients. It is much more challenging, but it is much more rewarding.
I was lucky enough to be in the very first cohort of pharmacists who qualified as prescribers back in 2003. There are very few times where you can describe a qualification as transformative, but gaining the IP qualification certainly is amongst those. The course itself is designed to allow pharmacists to register as independent prescribers with the General Pharmaceutical Council. All of the students are expected to complete 90 hours or at least 90 hours of supervised practice, or failing that, you can have DPPs who are either pharmacists or nurse practitioners who are experienced prescribers in their own right.
Studying the course at the university was very enjoyable. The most enjoyable parts were working with the lecturers. Some of the lecturers have been and are clinically practicing pharmacists, which means you not only get that theoretical side, you get the experience underpinning that, so you know how to translate that complex information into direct patient care. The equipment here is state of the art, which is very useful as well. It helps really refine those skills, and it is a great opportunity for working with other pharmacists across the region for networking, for support, and for ongoing connections and networks. I studied my CPD course at the university because I did my undergraduate degrees here. I knew how good the facilities were, how supportive the staff were, and again, that those staff not only had the expert knowledge, but had the experience to back up that knowledge. And when you're doing these advanced postgraduate courses, it can get very complex and you need to be guided by people who have been on that journey themselves to help show you the way, and that is what the university provides, as well as the state-of-the-art equipment, which allows you to practice your skills and refine your skills in a very supportive and interactive environment. I recently credentialed as a consultant pharmacist with the Royal Pharmaceutical Society of Great Britain, so my role is to hopefully move into a substantive consultant pharmacist post to further my progression. And one thing I have been contemplating in the future is whether I undertake a PhD.
Jonathan was a very enthusiastic, keen and capable pharmacist. He was very enthusiastic and determined to make the most out of the course itself.
For anybody looking to do a postgraduate course at the University of Sunderland, I would just recommend they go for it. The university provides state-of-the-art equipment, it provides a progressive learning environment, they're supportive and helpful staff, and in addition to that, these courses are essential, and they, for me, they were the catalyst of change to give me greater autonomy, greater satisfaction, and greater opportunities in my role.
If you are determined to improve the outcomes for your patients, and you want to also improve your own kind of professional practice, then the IP course is truly a transformative qualification.